The BBC presents Chapel Royal. Throughout the whole Christian world, the early English composers of church music are today a common heritage. Names like Tallis, Byrd, and Purcell are known the world over. These three composers, like many others, served the Chapel Royal. The Chapel Royal was not, as one might think, a building. It was a title given to a group of priests, musicians, and choristers who were in constant attendance on the English monarch, either at home or abroad. In this program, which is compiled by Dennis Stevens, you will hear works by John Shepherd, who was at one time a member of the Chapel Royal. The music comes from Magdalen College Chapel, Oxford, where for many years Shepherd was instructor of the choristers. The program is introduced by Alec Robertson.
The ways of biographers are hard. Sir Henry Hudder, writing about John Shepherd 30 years or so ago, in a little book on English music, spoke of his quiet, smiling, uneventful life. One would hardly describe Shepherd's conduct at Oxford in that way. He came there very early in the reign of Edward VI, and in 1542 he was appointed instructor of the choristers at Magdalen College, and fellow, afterwards gentleman, of the Chapel Royal in 1551. He was one of the 31 members for whom livery was ordered, probably for the coming coronation of Queen Mary. Now, it may be that his description as Master Shepherd of the Queen's Chapel went to his head, or that he was upset in not securing his doctorate of music. Whatever it was, he certainly got into trouble with the Magdalen College authorities in 1555 for having kept a boy in chains all one night and of dragging another boy, in his search for new choir boys, all the way from Malmesbury to Oxford, a matter of 45 miles. And so this allegedly quiet and smiling man seems to have been both quarrelsome and abusive. However, the fact that there is pepper in the cook does not mean that there is pepper in the soup, to reverse the old adage, and Shepherd was undoubtedly a fine composer, both for the Latin and for the English rites, adapting his style perfectly to each. This anthem, "Haste thee, O God, to deliver me, make haste to help me," comes from the chapel of Magdalen College itself, and it reflects the noble beauty of the building.
Thank you.
We may hope that Shepherd took the words of the next of his anthems that we're to hear to heart. They are, "I give you a new commandment, that ye love one another." This is a very moving piece, which was once attributed to Tellis, but it's certainly by Shepherd. The remaining pieces in this program all have Latin words and probably belong to the time in Queen Mary's reign when Shepherd had left Oxford and was composing a large amount of music for use in the elaborate ritual of the Chapel Royal. Eterne Rex Altissime is an ascension hymn in which the odd verses are in plain song, the even ones in polyphony, with the soprano part imitating the plain song tune in long notes.
Come on.
Three cantors in silk copes are directed to sing the plain song in the next piece for six voices, Non conturbata cor vestrum, Let not your heart be troubled. This is a responsory for Vespers, and you'll notice that the first bass sings a gloss on the plain song in notes of even length throughout the polyphonic part.
Thank you.
We're now to hear a portion of the responsory In Pace In Idipsum. In peace, in the self-same, I will lay me down and take my rest. This is a Compline response for the first and the subsequent Sundays in Lent, and several of the Tudor composers said it. Once again, plain song and polyphony alternate in this beautiful and peaceful set. We end this programme of John Shepherd's church music with the motet Haec Dies. This is the day which the Lord hath made. It's a motet for Easter Day, and it makes a strong contrast with the peaceful Compline piece that we just heard. It's scored for six voices with a gloss on the plain chant Easter antiphon in the first bass part. That was the case in the hymn we heard before, Eterni Rex Altissime. Haec Dies is a fine and brilliant motet with a great outburst at the end. Let us rejoice in this day.
The music of John Shepherd in the BBC series Chapel Royal was sung by the Renaissance singers, conductor Michael Howard. And the program came from the chapel of Magdalen College, Oxford.